Hello everyone, I am Dr. Arshia. I work as a senior resident dentist in Srinagar Colony branch of Partha Dentals. You can find us in a lane beside MG College of Engineering and Technology, opposite to Ratnadi on second floor above Everlast Roadway. So with day to day and with the help of these small videos, we doctors at Partha Dental, we slowly want to send a small awareness message in relation to the dental health, because if you see Indian population, a lot of people who are coming to our clinics, we find them to be very ignorant about the day-to-day dental problems which they might be having, and they because of their ignorance, they generally tend to come up only when the problem has become visible or the loss has become destructive. So with the help of these awareness videos, we doctors at Partha Dental want to send small messages of awareness which could be, you know, helpful for the patients so that they can relate and they can come down and get the treatments done at early stages. Yes, each and everything is preventable or curable at early stages. So with these awareness videos, we all doctors put a little extra effort to help people reach people and then to help them out, more specifically for the dental problems. So today's awareness video is all about the gum problems. So let me give you a basic idea that what is a supportive tissue. Each teeth has a supportive system. So each teeth in our oral cavity is not only supported by the upper visible gums, but it also has a supportive system which is called as periodontium. It's nothing but the just supportive and cushioning lining around the teeth, along with which you can find a bone between them. So a tooth supportive system is not only formed by the gum, but it is also formed by the periodontium, which is a cushioning layer around the teeth, and also by the bone. So a tooth health, vigor and vitality not only depends on the visible part, but it also is dependent onto the gums, onto the health of this periodontium, and also it is related to the health of the supportive bone. So what happens and how do these gum problems start and progress? So basically, each and every patient knows that there is something which is called as gingivitis. Gingivitis is nothing but it's just a gum irritation which is caused by ear plaque, the soft debris which generally you'll be seeing adherent to your tooth every now and then. So this plaque has a tendency to adhere near the gum lines, and slowly this plaque not only irritates your gum, when it is left untreated or when it is not removed properly or when it progresses. So this gum irritation or gingivitis slowly progresses to the underlying tissue and the bone, causing a greater stage of gum disease which is called as periodontitis. Now let me give you a small example. Please try to look at this video. Yes, so as you can see, this bacteria, plaque is nothing but an accumulation of the bacteria. So this bacteria, it has more tendency to adhere to the interface of your tooth with the gum. So with each and every daily, cleaning and brushing, and no patient will be able to remove this plaque or bacteria completely. So what happens if you fall short in a proper brushing or proper maintenance? This bacteria slowly starts irritating your gums and causes gum infection. This gum infection, when slowly starts progressing into the deeper parts or into the deeper tissues, it slowly starts not only irritating your gums, but after irritating your gums, it slowly starts accumulating over to the deeper layer of the teeth, and then it not only affects the gingiva, it affects the bone, and it also affects the surrounding cushioning tissue. So what happens when these supportive tissues are affected? As you can see, this slow process of growth of bacteria not only causes infection of gum, but it has affected your tooth. Along with that, it has started eating your bone. So this causes the supportive bone loss. And as you can see, your gums have started becoming loose, becoming detached, and you'll see their color have changed. They have become red, swollen, and they have become infected. So this infection through gums, slowly when it goes deeper and deeper, it not only affects your bone, but it also causes even body and these bacteria, they try to release certain kind of toxins and poisons. Release of these toxins and poisons not only disturb the tissue but also disturbs the supportive bone. When all this supportive bone and tissue is being disrupted, there is not only inflammation, there is a pus formation. And with this pus formation, that is a time when patient comes and says, "Okay, madam, I can see the plaque is visible, and I'm suffering from bleeding while brushing, bleeding while eating, and I'm also suffering from bad breath." So what could be the probable reasons for this gum infections to start? Basically, the most and majority gum infection starts because of lack of poor oral hygiene maintenance. People think that if they are brushing off or if they are flossing, then they are getting rid of it. But let me tell you, people, even brushing and flossing will not remove complete plaque and bacteria. There are hidden areas where your brush can never reach out. So when you make a visit to a dentist in every 6 months, yes, with the help of our equipment, we reach into that nooks and cracks areas and clean them properly. So basically, the major reason for gum diseases is plaque accumulation. Apart from that, gum diseases have found to be inherited from generations to generations. It can also be caused in medically compromised patients such as diabetes or other illnesses. And then it can also be seen when in a patient who has abnormal oral habits such as smoking, pan, gutka chewing and everything. So once this disease have become destructive, when does it become destructive? When it starts destructing the supporting bone, you not only eventually the teeth not only becomes mobile, but within a very rapid period of time you will be losing your teeth. So what could be done? What are the treatment modalities? Let us discuss the treatment modalities for such gum diseases. So as doctors we say, prevention is always better than cure. So if a person generally goes to dentist every 6 months to get a basic checkup done, basic cleaning done, it becomes very easy for them to prevent such diseases. Nevertheless, once your gums are infected, then when you make a dental visit, we as a doctors, we see for signs such as bad breath, bleeding while brushing, and we look out for the empty areas. Whenever there is a gum infection, so because of tooth loss or because of the bone loss, there will be a formation of pockets in between the two. So you will see empty spaces in between the tooth. So in between the tooth you will find empty spaces. So we as a dentist, we look out for such empty spaces. Not only for the empty spaces, we also assess your tooth for movements. If we see any kind of abnormal mobility, or if you are seeing any kind of abnormal mobility, or if you are generally day to day struggling while chewing, removing your food or debris which is being accumulating in those empty spaces, you are using excessive toothpicks, or it is becoming difficult for you to have non-veg foods and something, then you are definitely a patient of gum disease. So when stage 1 problem such as gingivitis, basically when a person has a gingivitis, like it is generally seen as a bleeding through gums, this can be basically treated by using by doing basic cleaning, which is called as scaling, and we can go a little deeper and clean the root, your tooth root part also, which is called as root planning. Apart from that, when gum disease slowly progresses, there will be some other kind of treatment modality such as deep scaling or with the use of cleaning the tooth of, with the use of lasers. And apart from that, when tooth have come to a when the oral cavity has a periodontitis or gum disease, a destructive gum disease, then we will be assessing the patient through all through x-rays and everything. After that, we plan a specific treatment for that specific patient, and with the help of advanced equipments available with us at Partha Dental, we will be planning a certain kind of treatments for them. Using lasers, we use artificial bone activators which help for the regaining of those bone. We do many other advanced surgical treatments, and yes, we do have expert dentists with us. So more than 107 successfully running branches, and with the very new inauguration of our 108th clinic also, Partha Dental have now become the leading dental chain clinics in South India, along with 300 specialist doctors. So at Partha Dental, we not only assure the patient treatment, we also assure the patient comfortableness, patient satisfaction, and we thus make our patient to be well aware of what and what has to be done and what we are doing in a step-wise basic and a specific process. So for any other query, for any other questions, or for any other discussions, you can directly visit us through website, that is www.parthadental.com, or you can call us for appointment at 91000 15150. And yeah, thank you so much.